Okay, I will cover two subjects in this lecture. For trends in ART, I would be summarizing the data from the European ART Registry in 2012, and then I'll give you some data on the ICMAT World Report, and finally, we'll review the study on cumulative live birth rate following IVF in the UK. For hot topic, I would be talking about a single frozen embryo transfer policy and end up with embryo banking followed by PGS for aging poor responders. Now for the first talk, this is the result generated by ASHRAE for the European IVF registry. As you know, ASHRAE has been compiling data for 16 years now, and ASHRAE gets information from national registry and voluntary data. This current report summarizes the result of IVF treatment initiated in 2012. So, each national coordinator from each of the 32 European countries would input national data directly into EIM database using a software developed by ASHRAE. And then this data will be analyzed at the headquarters in Belgium. And they would report like clinical pregnancy, delivery, multiple birth rate, and other data. As you perhaps know that the global need for ART is estimated to be at least 1,500 cycles per year. So using this cutoff limit, you can see that 9 of the 17 European countries that have 100% data coverage, they meet this criteria for adequate utilization of ART. However, another 8 European countries do not use ART often enough, so they have a somewhat underutilization of ART. So even among this so-called developed world, the European nation, they still have a lot of wide variation in the availability of ART treatment. So don't talk about Asia. I think in Asia, like in Thailand, the coverage is perhaps about 8 or 9% only. The IVF pregnancy rate per aspiration also vary a lot between different European countries. I have to look up the map to see where Montenegro is, because it has the highest IVF pregnancy rate. But unfortunately, I cannot see it on the map, so I don't know. And for ICSI pregnancy, it's a different story, because that top number become very low pregnancy. I do not know why. They are good at IVF, but ICSI pregnancy is very poor. I don't know why. But again, this ICSI pregnancies per aspiration also differ a lot among different European countries for unknown reason. And during the past 5 years, you can see that the pregnancy rate per aspiration of IVF and ICSI remain relatively stable. But the pregnancy rate for egg donation and frozen thaw embryo transfer are increasing a lot. But judging from this curve, I would challenge Professor Chen. He just said that freeze-thaw